I watched on Monday.
Yes, guys. Hello. How's everyone doing? Hopefully everyone's good. We are back with Mr. Josh Jenkins from JoshJenkins01 on Instagram.
Right, there you've got that wrong again.
What is it?
Dot1.
Dot1.
Right, start that again.
No, we'll carry on. This video, believe it or not, even though I've said that, it's not actually going to be too much about me. I also want to focus on Josh. So we are currently at the Grow Room. We are here for a Team Reecefit announcement that will be already announced, I'd imagine, by the time that this video comes out. However, this is basically going to be, for me, a D-volume delt and pull session with a bit of arms, a bit of biceps to conclude. I'm currently like 8.5 weeks out, which is pretty wild to think about, but that'll be covered on separate videos, so don't worry too much about that. This will more so be a sense of my session, Josh going through the session, going through some posing, announcing Josh as a Team Reecefit co-coach, which, to be fair, he's already been for the last like six months.
Yeah, a bit later than Finn. Finn and Noah got it announced, like what, 2 weeks into it?
Yeah.
Because he really cares about his business partner. Me and Reece have been doing it since July. Yeah, since June, July.
Yeah, I said to Josh, he's on a trial basis. I was like, he's got to earn me a certain amount of money before I can start promoting.
Do you know what it's like?
And now he's earning me some money. So I thought, you know what? He's paying for the video.
Do you know what
you're
it's
paying
like?
Paying for the video.
Yeah, I'm paying for the video. It's like, you know when, like, boys, you'll be able to understand. When you're texting a girl, but you're not really too sure if she's that fit enough. So then you don't really post her. You'll say you're out for a meal, you'll post her, or girls can do this as well. But then she'll be like, oh, why are you not tagging me in the story? That's how it feels.
Yeah.
Not that I've ever been in that situation.
No, in all seriousness, we should have done this months ago. We've literally spoke about this for months now, haven't we?
Yeah,
like,
but I have.
Josh has. I have as well. But I've legitimately just been like, I've been flat out, I've been away, prep starts, etc. And I said to Josh, right, we need to get it sorted. So we messaged Pete, we booked it in. And I think we sorted out a few weeks ago, didn't we? So yeah, here we are. So like I said, we're gonna be running through my D-volume session. Josh will be doing full volume. Josh is peak off season pretty much.
He's fat bastard.
As you can probably tell with his face. So he'll be absolutely fine when it comes to volume. So we'll just smash Josh there, see how he looks after the session. And yeah, just get into it. So cool, all good, right.
Sound, lovely.
That's it, sound. End of the video, imagine. That's
end of the video, no fuck off. What's that called?
I don't know.
So I say to all my clients, like, use this, but I don't know what, I say W.
I bought one of these when I was about 17. Matt Ogus, shout out Matt Ogus. He used to love these pull downs, and I typed in, I think it's a Y bar?
I thought it was a W grip. But I always get, whenever I Google it, it doesn't come up.
Should we put like a question thing on Instagram, like, what is this?
Yeah, what the fuck?
Let us know what the name is. Right, we're using this, whatever this grip is. If someone knows, let us know. But this is gonna be the pull down, so something vertical. For me, I usually do 2 sets. I'll see how it feels. If it feels good, I'll do 2. This is not that demanding. It'll just be the bigger movements, which, to be fair, for this session, for me, isn't that demanding, all things considered. So, yeah, 1 to 2 sets on this. Definitely not using this mag grip bar because nobody is that wide.
I am.
Yeah,
on a good day.
Yeah,
on a good day, I am. But
yeah, your waist is, but
fuck other than
one of them, like, maybe 1 or 2 more reps that would have felt like spot on. Like, it felt good, but you know, it's just like, I think it was all like 6 reps. Good. Come on, all the way. Yeah, good. Go again. All the way down. Yes. Yes, stay on that. Good. Yeah, love it. Do that. Sam, what's up? Right, so 2 sets for me, 3 sets for Josh. Started off with a neutral pull down. there's going to be a good amount of lat emphasis just with the elbow position, but then also there is going to be a good amount of upper back involvement as well. Usually I'd start off with a vertical base movement, usually single arms, just to get the mechanics and the alignment a little bit more suited towards the lat. But just with the availability of equipment, and to be fair, like, I quite enjoy like a neutral pull down. I connect well with it. I mean, it's just a decent exercise, isn't it?
Yeah, so pretty simple.
So yeah, three sets for Josh, two sets for me. We now have two main rows. So we're basically just going to have a look and go, what rows do we fancy? And go from there. I'm not doing
this.
Yeah,
you are. No. Rock, paper, scissors, come on.
No, mate, I'm only doing two sets on this. There's no chance of doing the stack. If you want to embarrass yourself on a video.
Yeah, fuck it. The way I see it, if you get any sort of stimulus when you're in off-season, you're fucking taking it the wrong way.
This is a fantastic advertisement for Josh Jenkins and his coaching. I mean, just any stimulus
at all.
If
any of my clients see this, don't do this.
Leading from the front. Got it. I don't think this will be
can
that
can we get a rep count on this as well?
You'll be good. You'll be good. Come on.
Can we get a rep count on this? Like an actual how many reps I actually do? It'll be about one, if I'm lucky.
Come on, let's go. Come on. Get yourself braced. Quality reps. Come on. Here we go. Come on. Here we go. Come on. Easy weight. There we go. Into it now. Yeah, sound good that. Come on. Good. Come on. Yeah, lovely. Good, come on. Chest up. There we go, there we go, there we go, there we go. Good, go again.
I'm not going again.
Pete, do not get that set on the video.
Send that to me, that's going straight away.
That was so bad.
The first three were all right.
Nah, it really wasn't, mate.
Right, don't get that video. Right, first
Pete,
set.
Get it. Video.
Here we just get so much stimulus.
Put it on the video, but like, you know when you blank, like you blur something out? So you just like blur, yeah, like, yeah, just blur. So you can see him somewhat doing the movement, but
it should be like. I had a good connection to my lat. Well, it wasn't my, it wasn't my lats, it was like my rear delts.
Yeah. Three, two, one, yep. Yeah, on me, on me, on me.
Seven, good, come on.
Ooh.
Finish off, come on.
Ooh.
Go for one more. Back in there, come on.
Ooh.
I wasn't sure if you wanted an assisted or not.
Nah, don't worry, it's all good. I felt good.
That's the thing, even if it's like way too heavy, it still feels okay.
You still get an okay connection. I feel like cable work when you've got an okay connection with your back.
That's the thing, one thing I will say is it hits the bottom way too early.
Yeah, the range of motion's almost like, you'd be better off if you get a bit more of a lengthened. Maybe if you were to extend where
to
your
feet
were.
To be fair, if this is a hack squat, it'd be perfect for you and Finn. You just don't get any range of motion at all. Sorry, Finn.
How dare you?
Quality, mate. Don't get sloppy. There we go. All the way back. Yeah, good. Come on. Keep going. Yeah, good.
Come on then.
When you edit this, please don't get Josh's just in between remarks, because I'm like almost cringing for him. I'm almost like, Jesus Christ. Like, this is one of those sort of things, you know, when like you look back and go, like when you've grown up a bit and you go, what was I saying? Maybe I'm prepping, maybe I'm the one who's being mean, but I think Josh in between every set has said something that I'm like, just be quiet.
Cheers, mate. Cheers, mate.
Mate, I've just mugged you off so bad on the camera.
What'd you say?
Oh, it's so bad.
No, at least
tell me. Wait till the video.
Fuck off,
Wait till the video.
I get the photo of you with gyno surgery.
Which one? The one where I'm like, oh mate, yeah, I've shown that before.
For fuck's
Come on, do your set. Come on. Josh, do you want to explain why you stand up?
I stand up because it fits me a bit better, because I'm a bit small. I'm 6 foot on Tinder, so I'm actually about 5'9" and a half. I've also got to wear Air Maxes or Vans, so I have to stand up so it fits me a bit better. Because if I sit down, it literally becomes like a rear delt row.
Yeah.
Which is not what I want.
Yeah, I didn't tell Josh to do it. However, mechanically, it looks like it suits him. And as mentioned, Josh is not the tallest individual.
I'm not, so I am.
There's a reason why I'm actually, like, I'm, if anything, on my knees right now. and I'm only a few inches smaller than it.
Yeah, go a bit lower, so actually look a bit lower. Taller.
So yeah, so we've got, I'm doing one set here. I'm just gonna match what weight Josh is doing really, and just get a few more reps.
Put six on?
Yeah, no, I don't know about that. And Josh doing two sets, do you reckon?
Yeah, two sets, but I'm gonna need something to put.
Yeah, I'll give you a hand at the start. Just give me a push. Go on.
Fucking hell.
You'll be cool, come on.
I'm gonna die. Three, two,
one. Yep. Yeah, easy. Come on, there we go, come on. Yeah, lovely then, easy. Good. Come on. Elbows all the way back. Go back. Good. Yes. Good. Come on. All the way. Quality there. Quality. Come on. Yes. Come on. Come on. Come on. Maintain composure. Yeah, there we go. Good. Yeah, look at that. Solid. It's fucking far, isn't it?
Yeah. Good mate, come on. Should I do like a 20 plus on like two?
No. Just do like a 3-plate set. I'll be just thinking about getting quality out of it.
Do you get what I mean? It is really far away.
It is, yeah. Right guys, so we are onto the final pull exercise. It's quite funny, I'm not sure Pete kind of caught it, but Josh was like, is this the last pull? I'm battered. And I feel like that's when like programming is pretty on point with what our needs are, because if we think about it, the first exercise was a vertical pull, dual arm sort of approach. We then went on to a cable row, which is funny because both of those first two exercises, I think a lot of people probably say are like slightly suboptimal, but if you do them well, granted Josh's first set was awful, but if you do them well, you can get a lot out of it. So that's more so a horizontal challenge. And then we move on to the hammer strength low row with a slight more upper back kind of bias based off the trajectory and line of force. So just one set there for me, and where Josh did too. And then we're now moving on to a single arm row. So we've almost, in a sense, ticked off kind of all planes. That vertical challenge, we've then done two kind of mid back and upper back emphasized rows. We're now still on a rowing sort of platform, let's say, like when it comes to the trajectory and likewise the challenge, but it's single arm and we're placing a bit more bias on the lat. So we're using the hammer strength plate loaded machine. I don't think I've ever seen this at any other gym. It's a,
not that one, though.
No, like there's a newer one. And basically how we'll set this up is we're going to be standing away from the actual sort of machine, so it results in a bit of a drop off. So ideally it's going to be heavier in the lengthened, where the lats are going to be stronger, and then because our lats are going to be at this point pretty fatigued, it's going to have a slight drop off as the weight pretty much passes over the actual axis of rotation. So some science stuff that you don't really need to worry about, but basically it feels pretty good.
I didn't know you were doing a working set.
Yeah, I was just going.
I thought you were doing warming up.
Oh, that was good. That's one of those, like, you have to be really accurate. You could do that for 50 reps if you just throw it around. Yeah. You strap if you want, mate. But just think really, like, let's say you set yourself 15 reps on this. Just get the best 15 reps you can get.
Yeah.
So that's almost what the main sort of aim should be. And then, like, brace into that leg and then think to pull your elbow into that hip. That's going to be slightly more push forward. It'll feel really light, but just literally think quality reps, elbow into pocket, chest a touch higher. There you go. Good. scap push forward for the set. There we go, better. Yeah, nice. Elbow into there. And think about literally driving it into the pocket. Nice squeeze. Good. Come on, quality reps in this, mate. Good. Good. Come on, slight pause. Yes. Good man. Good. Nice reps. And again. Good. Come on, quality. Don't throw it. Nice and slow drag. Nice and slow drag. Drag the elbow. Elbow into your hip. Shoulder blade forward. There we go. Into the side. Yeah, there we go. There we go. There we go. Good. And again. And again. Come on. Brace and go. There we go. There we go. There we go. Stay on that. Stay on that. Don't throw it. Don't throw it. There we go. There we go. Chest up. Yeah, good. Don't scrunch. Good. Nice. Good.
I get what you mean, though.
Huh?
So gradually it just creeps up.
Yeah. The first like five reps,
it almost just feels like an isohold. Just
the first five reps feel ridiculously easy. It's very easy on this as well to kind of demonstrate some kind of spinal flexion, especially like say through like the mid to upper back. So like your spine will start to kind of flex, and then it will recruit a bit more of that musculature. So maintaining that torso position and keeping it stable and neutral throughout is so important. So you would have heard me say to Josh, like, chest forward or chest up, and then like scapula forward, because ideally when we're trying to target the lats, we want our scapula in a push forward, like let's say protracted position. So yeah, one side there, one more side. Do you reckon just one set for you on this?
Yeah, I'll do one set, so my quad keeps fucking cramping up. It's lovely.
So therefore back training has to be pulled down. Huh? can't recover.
No. When you've got a tank top and you're like, oh yeah, you look physique now.
Oh, do I? Yeah. I actually look like a little physique guy.
Someone said that to me in the gym the other day, because they were like, oh yeah, maybe you actually do suit physique a little bit. With you.
Yes. Yes. Yeah, a little bit. Oh, fuck off. Do you more?
I was going to say it beforehand, but I was like,
I stayed under and I was like, come on, I'm giving you some.
No, but like, I was like, I was at that point like two reps ago and I was like, you're not here.
Okay. I tried my best, mate, I'm sorry. Oh. What's that?
I just clocked. I can't do this side when you do that side.
Oh, does it work?
Yeah, so should I do dual arm?
Yeah, if you want, mate, go for it. Yeah, if you're doing 2 to 3 sets.
Yeah. No, I'll still do like, I'll probably do one anyway.
Mate, I've got you're doing the same, but yeah, your biceps.
Yeah, my biceps.
Mate, you are a massive pussy.
Yeah, and what?
Like, you know, mate, you are sound. You're doing more than that. You've matched me volume.
I'm
under the weather, 8 weeks out, not obese. Mate.
Wait. So what are you saying about me?
He just stuttered then. He was like, you missed your chance.
So what did you say about me? You're saying that I am obese?
Huh?
You're saying that I am obese? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
On camera?
Oh, mate, blame me coach. It's not my fault I'm fat, it's my coach. That's what you should say, it's my coach. It's not
yeah, my coach is shit.
No, yeah, my coach is awful. Guys, do not go to my coach. That's how you should have spun
it. Yeah, don't go to Reece. He's fucking wank.
Yeah, exactly. Go to Team R Fit though, go to you. Come to me, that's what you should say.
Don't even go to me, because I'm just, all I do is whatever Reece tells me to do.
Yeah, exactly. Which clearly isn't working. Good, mate. Come on. Yeah, good. Nice. Come on, chest up. I was behind. Good. Does that not do your OCD, different D handles?
Yeah, it does.
For you, mate, like, I know what you're like. Did you drop the load slightly?
Do you want to get two of mine?
Mate, I'm doing literally one more set. So if you want to, as I said to you, go get your D handle.
All right.
I'm sound.
You sound like my mum.
Done. So we'll do a bit of a wrap up in a minute after we go through some posing, but that's pretty much the session. It's not too physically demanding, all things considered. And I know it was a devolving session. For some reason, Josh just fancied, even though he's been complaining to me in every single check-in, I want to do more, I feel like I can train more, I feel like we can do more. He's decided he's just going to do a devolving rotation with me pretty much. But overall, it was a good session. Like, I enjoy the session in the sense of it's not too physically demanding. You get a good pump, exercise are fun, you can have a bit of flexibility with it. It's probably like the only session of the week for me that isn't like I have to be doing a set press. It's just like pick a few rows, pick a few pull downs, have a bit of fun with it, get a good pump towards the end. So we're going to go through some posing. I've got prep tacks, therefore I'm going first.
Yeah.
Prep tacks, therefore
I've got secret prep tacks, therefore we're blurring everything out. Yes. Not that there's much detail there anyway.
Well, no, we said that we're going to be, like, throughout the prep, we'll be, I haven't actually told Pete this, but this is, we're basically, we're going to be doing
news breaking.
Yeah, news breaking. I want to do like a little mini series with Josh throughout the prep with Pete, so that'll be almost what we're looking for. So it'll be good to kind of compare and see the, like, pre-prep point, then potentially, let's see, starting
like
prep.
8 to 10 weeks from now, and then like a month out?
Yeah. No, it'll be, I'd imagine we'll probably do one. Like, we'll do it. We'll probably like two or three.
No, I mean, like, that's like 2 weeks. Like a month out will be good.
Yeah. So it'll be good to see. So, yeah, go through some posing and then we'll wrap up the video.
Sounds.
Cool. Right. We'll go down. Pete, there's a little corner down there. So come over. Yeah, I'm not fucking changing the
pose. That's one thing I need to get is a pair of shorts.
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
These dismissing the hard work, they calling it talent. And I find that disrespectful cause I put on the mileage. Up for the but I'm down for the challenge. Step off the scene just to find me a balance. These niggas don't want it to get it cause when it got hard, them niggas quit it.
I put in so much hustle, dog. It's all about that muscle, dog, yeah. Trying to make it out the struggle, dog, yeah. Ay, watch out this shit bubble, dog, yeah.
Look, shit, I chase here to make some real shit. Something that they feel shit. Cause all I know is speaking on some shit I really deal with. Like how I and in the morning didn't feel shit. Was tired of being single, so I went and got a real. Like how my homies quit and left this rap. So now I'm grinding dolo in they absence, no. But I'm still sticking to the plan cause I mapped it, no. And I don't care about going slow, just not backwards.
I put in so much hustle, dog. It's all about that muscle, dog, yeah. Trying to make it out the struggle, dog, yeah. Ay, watch out this shit bubble, dog, yeah.
Look, Nick don't really want it that bad. I see it clearly now. But me, I really want it that bad. My grind is eerie now. First I write the songs, mix the songs and shoot the videos on my iPhone, shit is serious, you hear me though? I ain't got no label backing me. It's just me and my girl. So when I blow up, I'ma give it a whirl.
To be fair, you probably have, so I don't know, I reckon you probably first time on stage, you got that back to Macca.
Yeah,
no. Josh has got a better back than you, Macca, the first time he stepped on stage. Oh yeah, of course. Yeah, wellness waist. That's what we're going for. It's a good shot, that. Hold that. Take a look at that. Nice one. At this current point, it's almost just a case of just doing the do, rinsing and repeating, let's say the basics. We've got a fair few tools at our disposal relative to training volume, food, even though to be fair, like food doesn't really need much more of it. But also like, let's say what we can manipulate and kind of pull in our leverage prior to a prep. So we're almost looking at this point right now to prime himself for a prep. And I think that kind of priming phase is so important. We're not running like a maintenance phase or anything like that. It's more so a sense of just getting him in the best spot, both physically and also mentally as well, ready for a very successful prep. And it'll be a bit of pressure because this was the show that I actually won the overall in. So
I think my second show is your second show as well.
Yeah, so basically Josh is just copying me when it comes to the shows. So
but the thing is though, if I don't lose to what, a teenager?
Yeah, you are.
If I don't lose to a teenager in my second show, I've actually done better than Reece.
Yeah, but he's actually got to win. He's got to win the actual first show. And I mean, Ethan and Pete, shout out Ethan and Pete.
Yeah.
And then I'm not too sure if anyone else is going
to
be doing
it. I've actually blocked them on social media. They don't know this yet, so I'm sorry, boys. I've actually blocked you on social media.
Yeah,
and I've got a dartboard of Pete's head. I just throw darts at it every night. And Ethan is now my punch bag.
Okay, yeah, same actually. Really good to get a session in, and like I said, really good to see where Josh is. We're going to be scheduling videos pretty much throughout his prep, most likely, where like every 4, 5, 6, 7 weeks, we'll get something scheduled, see him in person, kind of have a bit of an update, and it'll be on my YouTube, and then we'll make separate content for Josh's Instagram and stuff like that, and it'll be a sense of almost like, let's say, my prep will be demonstrated on separate videos, and then Josh's prep, and then as well as, let's say, my training will kind of be in the background. So it'll be really good to kind of, let's say, push Josh's content a bit further forward, and kind of, in a sense, level up where Josh
is. Hashtag level.
Level up. Everything's level up this year. So yeah, appreciate it as always, guys. We'll have the like name casts, or as Pete usually puts, so Josh Jenkins.
Josh Jenkins, like a fat bastard.
And then Reecefit, skinny.
Less fat bastard.
Yeah, less fat.
Skinny. Actually, no, hashtag fat bastard.
Hashtag what, you?
Yeah, hashtag fat bastard.
And then what am I, like skinny?
Skinny
deprived. Skinny deprived child. That's what I'm going with. So yeah, awesome guys. Right, anyway, shout out to Pete. He's been stood behind the camera for the last 20 minutes while I was just rambled on. Hopefully he can make a good amount of this and actually edit it to be good. And yeah, we'll leave it there.
Sound.
Cheers, guys.